Welcome. Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about callouts, how you can customize them, and a couple plugins that I like that utilize callouts or make it easier for you to work with callouts. What are callouts? Well, callouts in Obsidian are these little guys right here. You see, this is just from the Obsidian help. They've got a whole page on them. If you've ever updated your Obsidian, when you open it up again, sometimes there are release notes that will be popped open right in front of you for you to look at. And those will very often be in callouts with collapsed callouts at the bottom, giving you kind of previous updates that you can open up, go through if you need to. So even if you don't utilize them in your own notes, they're probably something that you have encountered just because they're used to relay that new update information. Now, personally, I go through phases where I like callouts, I don't like callouts, but I think I've pretty much settled on me really liking them. You know, they are really not markdown complicated. So let's say we do have to eventually move our markdown files to another note system or just work with them, you know, raw, so to speak. It's not gobbledygook. The information in the callouts, assuming you're not putting, you know, dynamic data view stuff in there and things like that, if you're just using them to relay hard-coded information, text, and stuff like that in them, it's super easy to look at a markdown version of a callout and see what's there. So it's pretty future-proof, and I do really like the visual nature of them. By default, there are quite a lot of callouts, and you use them just like this. So you put the little greater than sign, and then you put which callout you want, and then you just put your text underneath. And when you, by default, when you enter, you're going to create another little caret, or a greater than sign, rather, put everything in there within that one callout, anything that's got the little sign in there. That greater than sign at the beginning of lines has been used for ages in HTML and stuff like that for block quotes. It's super simple. One little character at the beginning of a line, and then you've got whatever the actual text of your note is in there. So another nice feature is, as you can see, you can collapse them. You can kind of fold them up, fold them down, and you can easily decide if you want them to be expanded or open by default or closed by default. So one of the things I do is I'll have a note in my vault about like a piece of software, and that will have links to other notes about that software. So if I need to, basically whenever I come across a problem with a piece of software or I learn something new that doesn't seem like it's a little unintuitive, it might not stick in my brain, I'll make a note on it and I'll be linked back to that main note about the software. And in that main note about the software, I'll have a little call out that by default is collapsed, and I'll have like, for example, like a license key for the software or a username and password maybe. That is by default, just like this, so the information isn't showing. Not that security is particularly, you know, relevant in my personal need for that sort of stuff. It's just a neat little feature. Or if you have a lot of information in some of these callouts about whatever, you know, whatever relevant info, but it doesn't always need to be there. You can have it just be collapsed when you open the note, so it's not taking up a lot of screen real estate. So it comes with a good chunk of them. You can see they've got icons, they've got colors that can be different between them. Some of them will work, will look identical, even if you put different names there. So you put the exclamation mark and then tip will give you this guy. But if you did hint, it'll also give you the little fire icon and that same color. But you can make your own. Now, in this same help file, there is a section called Customize Callouts, and there is a very simple little example that you can just copy and paste and change some stuff about. So I'm going to show you my custom callouts that I use. I'll go through why I use them and stuff like that, and then I'm going to show you a couple plugins from the community repository you can just install. So you'll save your CSS snippets into the .obsidian folder inside of your vault, inside of a snippet folder in there. So the root directory of your vault, .obsidian, and then in the snippets folder. And then you all have to enable each snippet that you want to take effect individually. In the appearance settings of Obsidian, if you scroll to the bottom of that section, There's going to be a CSS snippets header, which will list every individual CSS file in that folder that you can toggle them on and off individually. And doing so takes effect pretty much instantaneously. Now, the easiest way to make your own custom callouts is to make a CSS file, which is just a text file. I've got a few that I've made to customize my Obsidian experience. And when you make something that goes into the CSS file, basically it's going to carry over when you change your themes or when you change certain plugins that might alter your appearance. Your CSS snippet is going to stay active unless you manually go in and turn it off. CSS is basically a language that's used to just be for web pages, but now it's used to control the interface for a lot of different things. You know, Obsidian, of course, is a local program. It's not a web page that is on a remote server that you're using. And yet, CSS can be used to customize its entire interface. It's pretty incredible, and it's a pretty powerful language. It's certainly evolved over the years. So when you see my snippet, which is just, you know, copying and pasting that example and changing some values, understand that there is a lot more you can do with it if you really want to. These are mine right here. I've got a color. Now, callout color is obviously the color of the callout. This is going to be the color of the text on the icon, and this is going to be the little icon that we're using. But if you want to use a more minimalistic symbol and you want to choose a color for it, you know, you can use the same symbol for multiple callouts and have the color be different. You can have the color be the same for multiple callouts, but give it a different icon. So you can kind of visually categorize these in a bunch of different ways. Now, there's two tools that will help you out determining what you're going to put in these spots here. First, we've got rgbcolorpicker.com. Now, there's a lot of ways you can get this color. If you have Photoshop or Affinity Photo or something, and you see something on the web that you like, or if you use my favorite asset manager, Eagle, you can take an image, a screenshot of something or an image that you like, and you can actually pick that specific color in Photoshop, and it'll give you these values. But if not, if you just want to say, oh, I don't know, I want it to be like some sort of blue, but I don't know what kind of blue, right? You can go to rgbcolorpicker.com. You can mess around with these sliders, move this little guy around, and it'll change what value, what color we're looking at right up here. And once you get one that you like, once you get one that looks nice, you can take these right here, do a little copy and paste dance, and boom, slap it right into that file, that text file. And it just has to be a text file. So you can do this in Notepad. And you make something, mycallouts.css. Boom, simple as that. This is VS Code, but you can use any program that can write a text file. All you'll have to do is maybe after you save it, change the .txt to a .css, and that'll be it. So I've got my colors here. Now, I actually got these from a screenshot I took, and I'll show you where I got my inspiration for these. Inspirations in quotes because I flat out stole these. I completely ripped them off of a program that I really like that has recently started basically using a callout format in their app, and I really liked the ones that they used, and so I've started to integrate that into my vault because I enjoy it. Now, how do you get this other one, though? How do we get an icon? What is this? Align left, messages square, like chart network. You can kind of get an idea, hand heart. But what's this lucid? Well, that's going to be the next tool we're going to use is lucid.dev, lucide, I guess. I usually say lucid because that's a real word. And so this is an icon set, a very minimalistic icon set. And it's got a lot of icons, tons of them. And basically, this is already set up inside of Obsidian. So you can just search for what you want, either by scrolling down and just taking a look, or you can actually put some words up here and filter it out. So we got some dog-related stuff. We got a dog, we got a bone, we got a paw print. I want to use the paw print. Let's use that paw print, okay? So paw-print is what it is. Let's make a new callout. So I'm just going to copy and paste this one I got here. So that was paw-print. So let's change this, lucide-paw-print. Let's give this a new name, obviously. And let's call it, let's keep it simple. Let's call it paw. What colors are paw print going to be, though? What color comes to mind when you think of paw prints? Like, I think largely you'd think of like some sort of brown color, maybe. I don't know. Let's go with something like that. Let's go with that right there. It's a beautiful, beautiful paw print color. We're just going to do a little copy and paste. Now, let's save this bad boy. I'm just going to go into my vault, and here we can see those same exact callouts right here. So anecdote, advice, insight, notes. I've also got some other ones that I use for different like info parts of my notes. Resource links, license info, project goals, project links, references. Let me just go down here to the bottom. All right, let's just see what our new callout looks like. Look at that. We got the little paw print there. We got that color that we chose. Awesome. That's great. That was so easy. So easy. You know, I don't really like that color. Let's see if we can pick a different color though. Maybe I feel like a green. Let's try and get some sort of green. It's like a nice pastel green. Let's try that. We'll do a little copy, we'll do a little paste, and I'm gonna paste it in there. I'm gonna go save. And really, as soon as I click save and I open up that vault again, it's already changed. So in most cases, any CSS changes you make are gonna be pretty instantaneously popped up in your Obsidian. They're gonna manifest right away. So we can see now we've got that pastel green, very nice, very gorgeous. Love it, love it, love it. So I'm gonna have in the box below, there's gonna be a link to a text companion of this, and it's gonna have copy and paste of all of these callouts. So you can copy them and use them if you want, or you can copy them just to change them, do whatever you want. It's all yours, it's all mine, it's all everyone's. And just to quickly give you an idea of where I got these callouts from, I've made a couple videos before on the podcast app Snipped, which I love to death. Really, really enjoy using it. It's only gotten better over time. A lot of great upgrades recently, one of which was basically a Snipped is a podcast app that lets you very easily do on your earphones or hit a button on your app, and it will take the transcription of the last X amount of time, section out the audio even of the podcast, and separate those out for you, put them in their own little section of the app that you can share. And they'll also does some AI magic to give you like summaries and little like bullet point synopsis of what you snipped within the context of the greater podcast. I think it's fantastic. Initially, everything that you snipped, that's huge. Everything that you snipped would get this generic little note one, which is fine, and it would just look like this. And now, depending on kind of the item, the information within the snip, it'll give a little anecdote notation or an advice notation or an insight one, which is not, I don't have a screen cap of that one, but it looks the same. So I would just grab this color that they use. And I would grab a similar looking icon from that Lucite icon set. And there you go. That's super easy to make your own callouts. And, you know, not a lot of time investment. And, you know, if you're a visual person, and especially if you like to color code things. So if I show you my file explorer here, I've got little icons and I got different colors, right? Green, a yellow, a pink, blues, red. So that kind of correlates to the callouts. So the resource links and license info are generally going to be ones that are going to appear in technical notes or research notes. Project goals and links are generally going to appear in creative notes. Now, one of the things that you can also do with callouts is you can search for them. Obviously, you can search for them with the inbuilt search thing, and it'll give you anything that has that little anecdote one in there, right? You can change that to whatever you want. And another thing that you can do is you can actually use data view to create a table that will give you how many occurrences of a specific set of callouts appears in those notes. So as you go through and use callouts, if you do want to really keep track, you know, if there is some significance to them and you might want to see which callouts appear in which notes, you can search for them or you can set up a little dashboard type thing like this that will give you a count of how many is in each one, right? So this is only looking at these specific ones, but you can do it however you want. And this will also All of this data view call will be linked down below as well in that text companion. Now, if you do like callouts and you tend to use them kind of a lot, there is a plugin called Obsidian Callout Manager. And basically what it does is it gives you access to all of the callouts right from the command palette. So this is from eth-p, and you can find it on the community plugins repository. Let's get rid of this guy. So now we've just got some text right here, right? So I can highlight this, Command-P, Control-P. I don't know why I said Command. I'm not on a Mac. Callout. So Callout Manager has a bunch of options. Edit Callouts. Let's do that. So this is going to give you a whole bunch of different things. So it's going to show every callout that's available in Obsidian. This is going to be the default ones. This is going to be any custom ones you've added, any ones available from notes, any ones available from the theme you've got installed, everywhere. So there's tons you can see here that I've got, and you can go in, you can see them, you can edit them. Let's change the icon there, and it'll go through and it'll change that stuff for you. Very interesting, very cool. But aside from making it easy to edit ones, I don't think you can create a new callout with it. I think you'd have to go into there and make a snippet, and then you can edit it afterwards if you want. But another one is, it will also let you just wrap lines that you've got selected into a callout. So boom, we've got another Paul right there. As simple as that. Let's go ahead and inside. Boom. So it's super simple. You can do that to one line of text. You can do it to multiple lines of text. And one of the nice things is that because these are command palette options, you can easily assign hotkeys to them. You can pin them to the top of your command palette so that when you invoke it, it's going to be pinned right there at the top. As you can see, I've got a couple ones right here. So super easy to use. Very cool. I highly recommend it. Right. So let's say I've got a note for DaVinci Resolve. It links back to the DaVinci Resolve main note right here, and built-in silence removal in DaVinci Resolve. So boom, I got screenshots, lets me know exactly how to do it. Got little hand-drawn ones and twos step to follow. And then at the end, I've got a little insight call out just to let me know that you can only actually do this from a very specific part in DaVinci, even though the transcribe option is available in multiple places. So that's one way that I use it, just to clarify. And you can add those to the command palette pinned to the top by just going into the settings, and under core plugins, it'll say command palette, and you'll be able to just start typing and filtering out things that you want. And then once you select it, it'll be automatically pinned up here, and you can move them however you want. So super simple. Super easy. If you like to use callouts, especially if you've made your own, let me know what they are, or how you use them, because I just like them. I love the visual nature of them. I love that you can color code them or icon code them. I really enjoy it. So that's just me. Hope you have a good day. Adios.